And once, in the long ago, the place had been made and the table set. All the fineries and linens and place cards and trappings. The salad forks of days. When the tongs had scooped them out onto a dozen clean plates, the mouths that had watched grew fangs. When the pleasantries had exhausted themselves, when the minutiae of banter had ceased, they were left with their thoughts. And that was a cold dessert. To select the conversation like vintages of wine. To buy hope with currency. To supplant bank accounts with words. And to sell those words across borders of deeds. To let them take root within, until they themselves bred action. They had crawled into his ears, like ants as he lay idle on the grassy ledges. They had laid their eggs, which now hatched and told him stories, whispered stories. The past was beyond, they said. The past was a dream. The future was a swear. The future was a promise. To be broken, because all such lines which extend to the distance are in reality only line segments. It had made him think of the comfort that others partook in such familiar institutions. As religion, in such corrupt institutions as religion, politics, and needlework. For something had spun the tapestry, the cocoon, which had ensnared him. Something imperfect had woven those threads around him. Would it be found in the silence of forests? Would it be found in the icy death of snows? Could the mountains speak to him? The echoes of the valleys drifting up to the carved hills. They held no answer. Lonely cries of birds and wolves, which had known the summer, which had grown coats in anticipation of the hardships and the famine. He had to strip away layers until he became more human. Thank you. And what was left of the other sphere of humanity that he had envisioned? Had it really fractured itself? Had it broken upon the shores as if driven by a harsh wave of uncertain intent? Crystalline fragments of it still were to be found, embedded in the sand of memory and of current anticipations. What he reviewed silently, as the sirens' calls could only be heard between his ears, where the ants of summer had laid their eggs. What he heard then was ticking as a radiator cools. What he had hoped for within the jostling, the maelstrom, the crowd, the antics, the semantics, the aesthetics, were vaporized for him to inhale and exhale and pass on. Only a conduit, only a receptor, only a transceiver and transcriber. Yet, enough. When the call had come and the time had ended, when the mythological clock in the sky chimed that final hour, he wanted to look back on the days aligned, their links punctuated by action, their strength not within monetary things, but within the adherence to principle and courage and loyalty and beliefs, even if proven wrong, yet steadfast, yet true, in the nomenclature of his conscience. A window on a bright land, reflecting the hard, cold light.